makers of Zero Dark Thirty clearly want it to be the definitive film about the 10-year manhunt to capture or kill Osama bin Laden, claiming the film is, quote, faithful to the facts, truthful, journalistic, and living history, unquote. But if that's their claim, how come the first 30 to 40 minutes of Zero Dark Thirty are about how torture was instrumental in locating the courier who eventually led the CIA to bin Laden, despite the fact that the acting director of the CIA and the chairman of both the Senate Intelligence and the Senate Armed Services Committees have publicly stated the opposite? And should the film's seeming endorsement of torture disqualify it from awards consideration? The film stars Jessica Chastain as Maya, a hard-charging young CIA agent who's devoted her professional life to finding bin Laden. It's Maya who believes that the path to finding bin Laden is through the courier who helps deliver his messages to Al-Qaeda leaders and the media, since bin Laden would be too wary of surveillance to use phones or the internet. Maya and her colleagues attempt to locate this courier, an 8-year odyssey that involves surveillance, battles for resources, frustrating delays, life-threatening risks, and old-fashioned detective work. Based on a real person, Maya is a fascinating character that Chastain handles wonderfully, both because of and in spite of the fact that we know so little about her, she isn't the most likable person, and her single-minded dedication to her mission borders on obsession. The supporting cast, including Jennifer Ely, Jason Clarke, James Gandolfini, Chris Pratt, and Harold Perrineau, are all good and reflect the hundreds of people and the multiple organizations involved in finding and killing bin Laden. The film's natural lighting, verite shooting style, and attention to detail successfully builds tension while also showing the often unglamorous nature of intelligence work. And when the Navy SEAL raid to get bin Laden finally occurs, it happens in almost real time over 40 gripping minutes in a carefully reconstructed replica of the Abbottabad compound. But it's this attention to detail that makes the torture aspect of Zero Dark Thirty so baffling, infuriating, and unforgivable. It's been accepted for decades within the intelligence and interrogation communities that torture simply doesn't work and mostly leads to false confessions, strained relations with allies, prisoners made belligerent, insane, or useless, and families, friends, and sympathizers turned into sworn enemies. At one point, Maya says that getting bin Laden would protect the homeland. But after Guantanamo Bay, the invasion of Iraq, and the photos from Abu Ghraib, no one needed an order from bin Laden to justify attacking Americans or our allies. Some critics have claimed that the torture scenes in the film reflect the, quote, moral ambiguity of the torture debate. But since the torture in Zero Dark Thirty is shown to be so effective, with one prisoner actually saying, quote, I have no wish to be tortured again, ask me a question and I will answer it, unquote, and we're shown none of the many downsides to torture, the moral ambiguity amounts to, torture is ugly, but it works. For way too many people, that's not morally ambiguous at all, and is instead seen as the dirty but necessary work of war. But it's a claim as factually wrong and repulsive as saying, rape is horrible, but some girls are asking for it. In reality, there is no debate and no moral ambiguity about torture. Not only is it illegal, immoral, and counterproductive, it does not work. But Zero Dark Thirty, like the TV show 24, claims that torture does work, or at the very least, revives the myth that the jury is still out on torture, just as oil companies and Republicans want you to think the science of global warming is inconclusive. Zero Dark Thirty works as a crime procedural, but its irresponsible, destructive, dishonest stance on torture absolutely ruined it for me. And I feel Zero Dark Thirty should not be on any best of the year lists, nor is it deserving of Oscar consideration. I'm Jonathan Kim, and this is a Rethink Review. And if you want to hear more of my thoughts on the torture in Zero Dark Thirty, click the annotation here.